Once again from Tampa, Tom Gazzola and Chris Wescott, as the skills portion of All-Star Weekend is in the books, Chris, and we saw some interesting stuff that the league tried to spice up the skills competition. Some of it pretty good, some of it maybe they'll have to go back to the board again on it, but most importantly, if you're an Oilers fan, Connor McDavid making skills competition history. He becomes the only person to ever win in back-to-back years. That, of course, as fastest skater, 13.454 his time. A little bit slower than last year, but he said, Chris, that the track wasn't as fast today.
That's what he said. He said he almost toe-picked at the start, almost face-planted. He said that would have been embarrassing, but no, he's happy with it. I mean, he likes this. He likes the competitive nature of this event. It's pretty simple. Just skate as fast as you can. He's pretty darn good at that, as we saw out there. You know, the interesting wrinkle was that the hometown guy for Tampa, Braden Point, actually had the lead. He was the first skater through, and he watched as seven other skaters challenged him to it. Connor being the last one, of course, and then Connor beats him. Connor was kind of maybe expecting a little bit of booze, but instead they cheered pretty good.
The fans were gracious. Yeah. They've been actually quite tremendous all weekend long since we've been here. Anything else that kind of caught your eye? I know they started to do like the goalie streak, the save streak was different. It's kind of dragged on a little bit, but ended up being Marc-Andre Fleury winning with 14 in a row. Alex Ovechkin wins the hardest shot. Anything else that you saw?
I wasn't shocked by that last one. Right, I mean, Ovechkin can really.
Shea Weber's not here.
No, exactly. So someone has to take it, and Ovechkin has a wicked shot. So, no, one of the wrinkles, the goaltending streak kind of took a while.
Yeah.
And, you know, talking to some of the media, they didn't like that as well. I know some of the players didn't like it as well, but, you know, one thing I did kind of like, I liked the puck control relay just because it was so challenging. I mean, you wouldn't know it. Johnny Gaudreau's the first one through, and he does it in about 24 seconds. But then other people struggled with it. We saw Erik Karlsson basically bail on it, pick the puck up with his hand, put it on his stick, and then drove it through. And that got some laughs from the bench, and then other guys started to do it. I know Sagan did it because it was so challenging. So that's a good one because it is so challenging, and maybe it makes the players try harder next time they try it if they continue doing that.
The one that caught my eye was the accuracy shooting, where they threw in the wrinkle of lighting up which target you had to shoot at, and you know, it's funny, you could see some guys in their eyes, they thought that they would be shooting at one target, and then all of a sudden whoever was switching the lights would switch it to a corner target, different corner, maybe in the middle they put it right at the last second, and it caught the guys off guard, and you can tell in their mind they're just trying to shoot it at the target they thought was lit up, and then it changes. So an interesting wrinkle in that regard as well. Some other news today, Chris, in terms of the Edmonton Oilers, for the first time the Oilers are going to start a regular season as well as play some preseason action in Europe.
So preseason action in Germany. We don't know the city yet. They're going to announce those and the date, the actual date later. I really like that idea because if you're trying to grow the game in a country, what better one to do it than Germany when you have the best German player in the world on your roster? Send that team. So Leon Draisaitl, of course, a native of Cologne, Germany. We don't know the city yet, again, but
his dad coaches in Cologne as well.
So there's another wrinkle there, and I know he's got a lot of fans there.
Yep.
So that's pretty interesting. And then Sweden to open the regular season against the New Jersey Devils. I like that as well. Sweden, obviously, a brilliant hockey nation. And, and I'm sure that both these games are going to be well attended and fun to watch.
And keep in mind, too, that in Germany, they'll most likely be playing against a DEL team as well.
Yeah, that's an interesting, too. I like the local team angle. And I was talking to you about this earlier. I also like that they teach English at a young age in Germany. So we might be able to get some really cool storylines and talk to players on the other team that maybe some other teams that are going to different nations can't get.
Right.
So that's kind of a fun little wrinkle as well. And also, you know, that just drums up the local interest.
Absolutely. That'll be very exciting. I know Europe is quite the destination. And to watch NHL hockey there will be tremendous. The Oilers doing it for the first time as a member of the National Hockey League. Chris, you'll be covering All-Star festivities on Sunday as well. I've got you covered right here on EdmontonOilers.com.